Look, modders, Legend Slayer here. So today, today I'm creating a new world, and I'm gonna call it GTA Minecraft. So, make it creative. I'm gonna go to allow cheats on, everything like that. Make it super flat. I'm gonna create the new world. Okay, so now that we're here and got everything set up, first thing you wanna do is you wanna create a menu. So I'm just thinking green for the banknote, maybe, because we're kind of modeling this after GTA 5, so this is going to take a while to build, but we are going to try and do it anyway. So we're going to try and find something green. Maybe lime? Is there a light? No, it's only light blue. Light gray. Okay, well maybe we're gonna go with just emeralds. Emeralds seem cool. So you just wanna grab your emeralds. And first off, I'm gonna make it peaceful. Just because that's going to help us a lot more building, because there's not gonna be any stupid slimes in the way. Okay, so now I've been talking for a while, but this is, I don't know if it's this is me talking. It's basically build a room like you did in the Making of Black Ops 3 series. If you haven't seen that, you don't have to watch that if you want to watch this, but just if you're planning to make this GTA 5, just watch this and I'll go over everything that I'm doing, but it's more of a documentation than actually a tutorial. I'm gonna make this a wall of glowstone. Lights everything up. And now what we wanna do is we wanna grab a sign. This is just a really simple title screen, at least for now. GTA Minecraft. And then press to begin. So this is going to be kind of like a mix of single player and online. Because you could play this with your friends, I guess, but you know, it's not really built that way. It's not going to be built that way. So this is this. let me just grab myself a button. But that was supposed to be a minion. If you can tell. And then we're done. We're done with this room. So now I'm gonna go over, we're gonna make a second room. It's going to be the same height, Maybe same width, maybe not. You start with hands in GTA 5. Or GTA games, you know. Like any GTA game, you start with hands. And you pick up your guns as you go. So, using that knowledge, we are going to make the player start off with their hand. Block City, like almost like Block City, but yeah. Put that there. Don't listen. Crap. And then this command block is going to be driven. And that's that. Now that we've made this, I'm gonna go over. Maybe I'll keep it there. And then FM F3. So we're at negative 690, 375. Okay, so let's open up notes. -690, 375. And I don't know what the last number was. 581.300. Okay, so now we just select this. Copy it. Here it is. Okay. Actually, no. I have to TP at A. Or TP at B. Not at A. So, now I have to start building a city. Where are we going to build this city? Well, wait. First off, let's make this the spawn point. Oh. Yeah, that's that. Okay. So, now we're going to build a city. We're going to build it walled off. Almost like we did with shipment. So yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Just have to build the city first, but you're saying we're probably going to make it walled off in the end, because there's no other way to obstruct those buildings. Okay, so the first building, this is where you're going to spawn in. I'm just going to mark it here. This is where you're going to spawn in. And then the rest can just be the road. box of gold. Don't even know why. Actually, you know what? That could make for a good quest. So, what I'm going to do to substitute missions and heists and things like that is I'm going to make a sort of quests thing. Basically, what's going to happen is I'm going to make it so that you can choose to follow these sort of heist things. And someone can give you a pickaxe in one of the missions and tell you that there might be gold in the road. So yeah. That would be cool. And then we have a gold exchange, yeah. That would actually be awesome. The cool thing about this is we can actually properly wall it off, because there's not going to be any boost jumping or wall running or whatever, and you can't get over the wall, and you can't see over the wall, so that's going to be cool. That's going to be what stops you from realizing that this is a game. It's all a game. All of it. One big game. Okay, so I'm gonna put the first building here. There. It's gonna be not so high that you, like, if you fall off, you die. Well, maybe. I mean, I don't know exactly what that block height is. Make it one more wide. But this is going to be a store you can steal from. Store you can steal from. So we're gonna need a door. Any door will really work. I like oak doors though. So we're gonna use an oak door. Where I am. And then I'm gonna grab some andesite, some polished andesite. This is what we're going to make the floor out of. So every one of these buildings has to be detailed if you're able to walk inside it. I'm going to show you how to make a building that you're not able to walk inside as well. It's going to be tough to do, but I will show you how to make windows that you can't see through. Or walk through. Hang on, using the wrong brick. What the crap? Why do I keep removing stuff that I'm gonna need? Okay, now I need glass. Okay, so this glass is. So right here, we're gonna have a villager. Who can't get out. So yeah. Okay. So we're gonna need a spawn egg. Villager spawn egg. Hello. Hello, villager. Oh, that's great. Jumped over. Well, unfortunately, Mystic Villager, unfortunately for you, people who jump over that. That was a nice kill. Okay. Well, now, Mr. Villager, let me just, I'm gonna bring you back to life. Oops. Villager spawned. I'm gonna need a sign, actually. And I already have. Wow. Wow, that is just bad. Anyway, guys, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed. Leave a like, leave a comment, and as always, guys, peace out.